Control here. This is XCAV of the Starship Dead Thoughts contacting ground control. Can you hear me out there, ground control? Can you hear me? Oh, we're on a delay. Okay, do a woo if you can hear me, ground control, because we are moving and grooving. You hear me. Oh, amazing. Ground control, how's it been down there on Earth? All good? It's been okay up here. Let's see, who hears Ixie? Give me a hell yeah. Hell yeah. Wow. What an exciting time. Okay, so I'm Ixie. Like I said, I'm XCAV of the Starship Dead Thoughts contacting ground control. Ground control, give me a woot-woot. Give me a woot-woot. Ground control. Okay. So, this is interesting because we've never actually been up here in space before. And I do appreciate the constant updates from Earth. This has been really great. I really appreciate it. Over the past couple of months, ground control has been really incredible. You're all honestly the reason I get up every morning. So, thanks for that. That, and also, well, I can't die. I can never die.
Hey, everything's good. Everything's really good.
Okay. I'm so sorry, ground control. This is my intern, Billy Intern.
I'm Billy. I'm Billy Cosmopolitish. You don't have to remember my name, but I'm here and everybody looks great. I'm having a great time. I just want to thank you so much for giving me this opportunity. It's not paid, but, you know, I'm learning experience.
Okay, neat.
Yeah. And just because of the occasion, I wrote a song. I wrote a song for you and about friendship between us and hardship and a couple other kinds of ships. And that's it.
Okay, bye.
Oh, okay. Yep. Well, I'll just
ground control. I'm hearing something about woot snack pack. What's a snack pack, ground control? That is not something that we prepped for. What is snack pack?
You take one down, you pass it around.
Oh, do you hear that? That's the sound of my crew. It's my crewmates manning their station.
Yeah.
It looks like it's going to be another great day with my team.
Yeah. Hey, Ixie.
Hi, Artie.
Hey, Doofy.
Hey,
turn
Doofy.
On your
hey,
Doofy Dog.
Hey, Doofy Dog.
Doofy Dog is so funny.
It's a little hard.
So long to hang out with you, Doofy Dog. You're so cool.
Yeah, you really are the glue that holds us together when we can hear you.
Yeah, we could hear you talking.
Doofy Dog still hasn't gotten the hang of our system. Doofy Dog, you gotta press on mute.
Oh, shucks. Sorry about that, fellas. I just love you all so much.
You're a riot, Doofy Dog.
I can't believe it took us so long to hang out with you.
This guy, I'm telling you.
Tell us a joke, Doofy Dog.
Why did the chicken cross the road?
Oh, that is the funniest joke I've ever heard.
Doofy Dog, without you, I don't think our little family would have survived the last year. It's been so difficult.
Yeah, I mean, who would have known that the whole planet would have grown a mouth?
Yeah. Well, I know it's been tough, but I do appreciate you all joining me on this scientific exploration. I've been monitoring deep space. And finally, I've discovered something amazing.
Is it a cure for hiccup?
Oh, you feel good to laugh, Doofy Dog. I love you.
I'm indifferent towards you, or
everyone say hi to Manu in Guelph, Canada. In Guelph, Canada.
Hi, Canada.
Hi, Canada.
And say hi to Dan Ballard. He's from the South. He said howdy.
Howdy.
Howdy, howdy Dan. Yeah.
Howdy, friend.
Okay, well, we've had a lot of fun, but now I'm going to tell you about the important thing. So what I discovered is a sound deep in space. A sound I've never heard before.
Someone saying, I love you, Ixie.
Oh.
Scram! That is hurtful. Imagine someone saying that to you. Think you owe Ixie an apology?
I'm sorry. Goofy is right. I said it because I want to be loved. Thank you for freeing me, Doofy.
I accept your apology, Scram. And while the pain of being wholly unlovable does sting, I appreciate Doofy giving us this opportunity to strengthen our friendship and the bond and relationships of this entire group.
Agreed.
Jinx! Jinx again!
You buy me a goat! Okay.
Okay. Well,
what a goofball.
Hey, can I play over here? I'm a goofball too. Can you?
All right, take it easy, Artie.
Okay. Well, we're getting a request for Shivo. Shivo couldn't be on this mission. But you know, if you want someone who's a little killer pink monster, then you know where to look. You know where to look. And it's not the White House. Okay.
I get it.
Okay, can I talk about my invention now? Thank you. Okay, this could be it. This is my biggest discovery. Okay, this is the one, guys. It's like the big invention. This could be it. This is the one that finally gives my life meaning and fills the hole that, you know, has been left there from my parents abandoning me as a child. And it's going to just finally melt off me like sludge from a car.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Wow.
Well, that celebration for a song.
Yeah,
tonight.
Let's have a song for
baby
that.
Baby shark, doo 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 shark, doo 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 doo.
Baby shark, you mortal doofuses! Eons ago, I emerged from the primordial dust. I am older than the Big Bang. I exist outside of time and space. My sole purpose is to travel through the universe and seek out sentient life in order to destroy it. All sentient life disgusts me, and it's my duty to separate you from the gross, from the pathetic, for I am Ted!
What's happening?
Together, and if we die, my spirit will guide us through ascension.
Oh, God.
Oh, something's up ahead.
Ah! Oh, yeah, my God. I peed.
Oh, my God. My last moment alive will be Jeff peeing all over me. I knew existence was useless.
Oh, no.
Brace for new
one. Oh, no.
Oh, my God. Oh, that was scary. A lot more pee came out than I thought would.
Oh, God. Ground, you know what? All I learned from ground control through all of that is that Stephanie's here.
Good.
Great. Okay. That helps.
Yeah. Thanks, Stephanie.
Thanks, Stephanie.
That felt cool, though.
Yeah.
It feels like my insides are on my outsides.
Yeah, great.
Oh, what do you think, Doofy?
Well, I think we were maybe just sent through a space and time into interdimensional isolation prisons.
Silence, mortals, and also hello, Stephanie. That is absolutely correct, Doofy Dog. I did, in fact, send you through space and time into interdimensional isolation prison.
Oh, shucks. I knew it.
Can I have my insides on my outsides again? Just for a while.
Silence, mortals, and yellow thing.
Who are you, anyway?
I am God.
The real God? Is there a number so high even you can't count to?
Why do good things happen to bad people?
Why am I so dumb?
Is it true you made bananas look like that on purpose?
No, hush up, you guys. Like, stop. Like, stop talking. No, I'm not like the God. Like, compared to y'all, I'm like a lowercase g God. But I am Ted, business lord of space.
Oh, so you're like an ancient being that lives a long life and is possibly the inspiration for God archetypes that appear in our history and mythology, kind of like that Star Trek episode?
Live long and prosper.
Today's a good day to die.
Darmok and Jalad.
No, that's not it. Look, I'm not a nerd, and yeah, I saw Ancient Aliens and I saw Chariots of the Gods, but that's not what we're talking about. I'm much more sophisticated and interesting than that, okay? And let me finish my thoughts. I, Ted, travel through space and time in the universe to seek out mortals and make them answer riddles that are not good riddles at all, and answer who decide. I decide who lives.
I farted.
I can smell it and hear it from space.
I can smell it in the cockpit.
But it was silent. Oh no, I smell it.
I travel from the universe and make sentient life forms answer questions, decide who lives and who does not live.
Wait, you mean like a game show?
No.
Yes?
No, not a game show.
Wait, this is like an episode of Star Trek.
It's not like that. This is serious. And to prove how serious I am, I'm going to kill one of yous right now.
No!
Oh, please don't, sir.
Please don't. We're a family. There must be some other way, but if you have to kill one of us, we all agree it's Scram.
What?
No.
I'm sorry, Scram, but we've all had this talk like 20 times.
Jeff!
Well, you know, Scram, we wind up in situations like this a lot, and you're never at house meetings.
I always vote myself, Scram, but if it makes you feel any better.
I mean, yeah, it does, kind of.
Oh, silence! I get to decide who gets killed. And it's you!
Doofy Dog! He killed him!
As I was saying, I select who suffers and who gets solitude, never to return unless you pass my simple inquisition.
Inquisition!
That's right, Inquisition!
Yes, Inquisition!
Yeah. Inquisition. I love Inquisitions.
You guys like Inquisition down at the tavern by Town Hall.
Yeah. We love Inquisition.
Oh, yeah. I love Inquisition.
How is that dog still alive, though?
The power of positive thinking.
Oh. I have an Inquisition. Can you make my insides on my outsides again?
Artie.
Well, all right. Look, everyone, just be quiet. Because now you are all unwilling contestants on Ted's intergalactic game show called Ted's Inquisition. And for each correct answer, I shall let one of you out of your interdimensional prison cell.
Okay.
Cool.
Again, it's supposed to be a bigger response, but that's cool. Anyway, and for each one you get wrong, one of you will die.
If we work together, nothing can stop us.
Yeah. With Doofy Dog on our side, we can't lose, and honestly, everyone on ground control agrees.
Yeah, well, what the actual frig, though? I thought I killed that dog. Here I go again.
He keeps killing me, and I keep resurrecting. What am I, Martha Stewart's career?
I thought that was funny.
Okay. Look, please stop killing our friend. We'll play. We'll play along.
Yeah.
All right. The blue thing is smart, And to show you that I am not unfair and I'm slightly benevolent, if that's a thing you can be.
Okay, I'm not just a blue thing, though. I'm actually a human.
I'm pretty sure he was talking to me. I'm the blue thing.
It is confusing that we got two blue things. It is hard for you to know who I'm talking about, but it was...
I'm the yellow thing.
There's two yellow things, too.
I'm blue and yellow.
The bottom half is blue.
I'm also blue and yellow.
Hey, what color would you be if you could pick another color to be? You know what I'm saying?
We'll no longer refer to people as colors now, all right? We don't see color anymore. I'll try to use better descriptors for you people, all right? You people and animals. Listen, here's the deal.
Thank you.
So we're going to play this. We're gonna do the Inquisition thing. And to show that I'm not a bad deity, I'm going to let you use some help from ground control. All right? So it's in your hands. And in your hands now. What do you think of that? Ground control, you got it?
Okay, ground control, you're going to help us solve these riddles. You better be good at them.
Yeah, because if you don't do it, people are going to die. You got that, right? Huh. You get it wrong, they die. You get it right.
Yeah. I send them back to Earth. Pretty straightforward. All right. If they don't get it, they've got more problems than we have.
Okay, yeah, I get it. You're all at home on a Sunday during a holiday. I get it. It's tough. All right, here's the deal. So now we will begin. With riddle number one, who will be? Okay, fair enough. Your riddle. What is your name?
Scram.
Artie.
No, it's my turn, Artie. I'm Scram.
I was talking to him, the other guy. All right, your riddle. What? Here is your riddle.
Okay.
What walks on the longest legs in the morning, the shortest legs in the afternoon? And one wheel in the evening.
Oh, that's real tough. Ground control, what do you think it is?
Okay, well, we're on a little bit of a lag with ground control, what with us being so far deep into space and them being on Earth.
Oh, yeah.
And, probably, and seems like in a lot of different places, like Canada.
Canada.
But we do have one guess, and it's...
Choose wisely.
Okay, they said choose wisely, and we have one guess, and it's from Joe Moore, and he says he's bad at riddles, so don't necessarily trust him, but candle or egg?
A toilet.
All right, you're supposed to wait till we get more guesses from Mission Control, because you only get one answer, and it's...
Yeah, am I right?
Yeah, it's a toilet. Send you back to Earth. I don't even know how that happens that quick. That's not even cool. I don't even like it. All right, who is next?
Wait, are you gonna send Scram back home?
I already did. Send him back to Earth.
Okay, it's a little laggy, so I didn't know that. Okay.
Yeah, you're all are in different rooms of a spaceship.
Okay. Okay, who's next?
Oh, the pink thing. The pink guy. Pink guy, you're next. All right. The next riddle for the pink guy. All right. Hopefully, we still have people in Mission Control ready to help with this Inquisition. Riddle number two. What has roads but no cars? Cities but no people? And rivers but no water?
That's it?
Yeah. What has... Roads, but yeah,
already. But I want to hear what ground control says.
Are we getting anything from ground control? Because I don't have all day.
They're a little confused about how the last one was a toilet. Can you re-explain that one?
Nope, passed it.
Okay,
we have moved on.
Okay. Someone said Saskatchewan. Oh, Zach Ogle said a map. And so did Katie Jeffries. Katie Jeffries said, map.
Map.
Jeff, do you think it's a map?
Oh, I think it's a map. I know
map.
That's my final answer is, what?
Go ahead.
My final answer is map.
No one's ever gotten two of my riddles back to back like this. It is a map, all right? You will go back to Earth.
Thanks.
Now there's nobody in the engineering room of this spaceship, which is a big problem. All right, lady, it's up to you now. So, I better make this a tough one.
Okay, I'm ready for it. Ground control, you ready?
All right. And for you, I will use one of my hardest riddles.
Okay.
What is my cousin Dan's favorite snack?
Oh, that's a hard one.
Yeah, it's tough.
Oh, shoot.
Yeah, I'm tough with my riddles.
I'm gonna dig deep into my brain library. Digging. Okay, ground control, any ideas? What is his cousin Dan's favorite snack? Okay, these aren't my guesses, but I'm gonna start kind of saying things out loud. Okay, so maybe rocks, maybe
penguins. One answer you get.
I'm not gonna make you
suffer for the last one because you didn't say it was your final answer. We're channeling Regis. May he rest in peace. Another 2020 loss. But what do you, come on, you got it.
Cheetos, we're hearing Cheetos, tasty cakes. Okay. I'm gonna go with Stephanie Phillips, since you know she helped us so much through the crash into space. Her guess was beer nuts. Is it beer nuts?
Sure. Yeah, sure. Yeah. Sounds great. Yeah. Ready? And I'm gonna send you back to Earth. Are you ready for it? Oh, now there's only one left. And we'll get back to that later, I think. At a different time. Because that's it. I'm all out of riddles for now. We'll get back to the rest of who even knows what's gonna happen now that all of them are out of riddles. Hey, are we ready down there, studio? All right.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. We made it back to Earth.
Yeah.
Safe
Thank
and sound.
Yeah, I was beginning to think we'd have to eat Jeff, which still sounds exciting.
Wow, we made it back. Well, Artie, you're still in space. You're still in outer space, Artie.
Ah, shucks.
That's right.
I'm still in space.
You're right. Your little yellow lizard bird rat thing is still stuck here in space with me forever. Because even though you answered three of my riddles, I grew up with money, so I'm mean and rude, and I don't keep promises.
Ah, hey, come on, Ted. Be nice.
Forget it. You'll never get them back. Not unless you have $400 for interstellar bus fare.
Wait, what? Are you telling us that all we needed was bus fare to get away from you?
Yeah, duh. It's free country.
Doofy Dog died for nothing?
No, it wasn't for nothing. It was very funny when I killed the dumb dog.
Oh, whatever. Let's just get this over with. Come on, Jeff, get in the bus here. Let's get Artie home. This is stupid.
Let's see here. Ted, do you take Diners Club?
Jesus
Christ. No, nobody takes Diners Club anymore, except the boardwalk in Ocean City and that Alaskan Blockbuster.
Well, I don't know what we're going to do then.
I'd pay for myself, but all my money is tied up in doubloons and PPP loans.
Artie and I have a joint bank account, but the bank is the fridge and the money is the mud pie, and Artie eats all the money.
Oh, wait. I have an idea. But we're going to need ground control's help. Are you ready, ground control? Will you help us?
No, Jeff, that's my thing. You can't do that.
Oh,
all right.
Only I can talk to ground control.
Okay. All right. Sorry.
Okay.
Well,
so.
Oh, there you are.
Are you going to ask him?
I just don't like that Jeff was like stomping on my territory.
Yeah,
sorry.
Jeff, you got to be cool about this.
I mean, I was just, you know, trying to help.
Like, did you think I couldn't do it because I'm a woman?
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, I see. It's because I'm dead.
Yeah.
No, what?
Okay.
That's ridiculous.
Ridiculous, huh?
I'm gonna ask. But I also lost them for a second, so hold on one second.
Also, there is a delay we have come to learn.
It's a good point. Okay. Ground control. Everyone's so loud. Ground control. Will you help us? I'm waiting for them to tell me if they're gonna help us.
Okay.
We're hearing, in the meantime, we're hearing Geese Jeff and Wild Jeff.
Come on, I didn't, seriously, not what I was thinking at all. I was not thinking that.
Ground Control, are you going to help us raise $400 so we can get Artie back?
What do they
say? Yes, they're saying yes.
Oh, good. Okay, good. Good.
Okay, well, in which case, okay. Oh, we're hearing anything for Ipsy. And I don't know how to add it.
What did they say about me?
They said Scram owes Ipsy 40 dead fighters.
Artie, can you hear that?
Well, I'm glad to hear they're so excited because
they're gonna help us. Everyone, we're gonna pause for this quick interlude while we get everything set up.
Yeah, okay, Billy Intern, help us out.
I think his name is Billy Intern.
I'm Billy Boy, and I'm here to tell you, you got to come down here and get your paper, wall to wall paper, one end of the wall. You got paper. Other end of the wall, white paper, 1, 2, 3. You get paper, you're going to get paper. Just don't, because if the boss finds you puked on this paper, it's all over for me. Billy Boy, paper guy. I could have done a song. I don't want to talk about it. It's blue. I have a blue shirt, and
you know what I mean? Not me, though. I'm great at pressure.
Keep stalling!
Hey, look at this. Look, we have little guy Ryan here. Ryan, why don't you show off this amazing banner you made? Wow, how about that, everybody at home? If you just call in and give us some money, we can bring that little guy Artie home. And hey, you know what? I need a new car, and I need a couple of new shoes, and I owe some people some money, so maybe when you're throwing in the 400 for bringing Artie home, you throw some money in there also for good old Scram, hey? How about that, Ground Control, for your buddy old pal Scram, just like, why don't we fix up that angle there, buddy? Should I do this?
One more minute.
I'll do this. One more minute.
20 more minutes of stalling.
Okay, I'm going to teach you all about sigil magic. Now, the most important thing with sigil, I probably should be talking about this on TV. Jeff, what kind of magic can we talk about?
Frenetic.
Frenetic magic. Frenetic magic is a special type of magic. It's when you take some fried eggs. Jeff, would you act this out for me, please? You take some fried eggs.
Right, like this.
You take a telescope. And you put up close to the fried egg. Yeah, there you go, like that.
Hey, there are my keys.
Yeah. And then when you try to find the heartbeat.
We're not quite ready. This is the magic of live theater, folks.
Okay. Welcome everyone to Dials for Darty, a telethon where you can call in and send money to get Artie back from space. Ixie AV will be taking your phone pledges all night so we can get to that goal of $400.
Yeah, and with your pledge, where's my camera? Where's my camera? Which camera is my camera? This is my camera? This is my screen? With your pledge, not only can you get Artie back home, but you can also get this mug.
Release my soul, you witch!
It's the ghost of my dead landlord trapped inside. With your pledge, you can get a whole lot of happiness. Okay. Are we ready?
All right, let the telethon begin.
Okay. So, Ground Control, what we're going to do, and we're hearing that we're getting some money signs. We're getting our people want us to use our COVID stimulus.
Hey.
I'm just trying to open my camera back up, my own personal camera. I'm entering the system. Okay.
All right. Now we are ready to take your generous offers.
Okay. So here's what's gonna happen, Ground Control. We're gonna have friends do this telethon with us, and they're going to be so generous with their time. And so what you're going to do is you're just going to enjoy, sit back, relax, don't poop yourself, and enjoy our very first performer and entertainer. And that very first performer and entertainer is Mr. Joe Moore, the scientist. Give a round of applause.
Oh, hey, gang. I'm so glad you found me here on vacation. I wanted to help you and anyone at home who's looking to get in touch and to make visual contact with Artie. You'll be able to do that. All you need is just a simple, small telescope here, if you have one of these. And what I want you to do is you're going to use these three fingers to help locate Artie. What you're going to do is you're going to look up into the sky. Now, you'll notice, again, I'm on vacation. The sun is still out here. This is very dangerous to do, so make sure you do it with a parent. If you're a kid, where you all are, the sun should be getting down a little bit further along. But I want you to start to look up, and if you can find the Big Dipper, I want you to put the tip of your middle finger right on the Big Dipper. Now, if you do it all the way at the far left terminal point of the handle of the Dipper, then you're index finger will be just about cresting on, you see that, on the one right next to that, to the right of the end of the Big Dipper in the middle of the handle part, and then your ring finger will be making a line into space. There's no star there. There's no star at all. If you follow that all the way up, follow your ring finger up about 2.5 inches, you're going to begin to see a cloud, what would be like a nebula, we would call it, and in that nebula is where you're going to find Artie. So, again, you're going to use this, and I want you to keep it away from the sun. You don't want to do that. Where I am on vacation, it's a little sunny here, but by you, it's not so bad. So once you get, again, off your ring finger, follow that up into the cloud. You'll see some purple. You'll see some yellow. You want to get in. That's where you're going to target your – oh, there we go. I can see all sorts of – oh, it's beautiful. All sorts of beautiful stars up there. And once you get in, if you follow it, then you're zooming in. You use these little twisties knobs, and oh, no, ow! I'm looking at the sun. Let me switch to my other eye. It's so hot. It's so hot, but I think I can kind of see Artie. I think I can kind of see Artie there. Oh, boy. Oh, and then there you have it. All right. And then that's it. Then you'll see Artie. We want to ask everybody to please give generously. It's a long way, as you can tell. If you got Artie in your sights, it's a long way to get him back, but we're going to get him back home. Thanks.
That was very informative.
So we'll think of next.
Probably he'll think of a second sun, or maybe a second moon, or maybe a world in which the sun and moon marry each other and make little moon babies, and then maybe the babies will be like happy, you know, and they'll grow up in like a really stable home.
What kind of funny thing will Joe think of next?
Okay, our next guest. We have an absolutely incredible, entrepreneur / religious fanatic. He asked to be personally described as such. Give it up for Otto.
Has likely peeled a banana. But did you know that you've been doing it all wrong? When most people, in the event that they are peeling a banana, or to peel a banana, they peel it in a manner thusly. See? But did you know that in the animal kingdom, monkeys tend to peel their bananas from the bottom in three easy steps. First, they pinch what to us we perceive as the bottom of the banana. Step two, peel from the peel of the banana. Finally, step three, congratulate yourself because you are as dumb as a monkey, which is nearly as good as being as dumb as a person. There has got to be a better banana. Do we not have a better banana because there is no better banana? Or do we not have a better banana because we lack the imagination to dream of a better banana? I had a vision. I was in the lake washing my balls one misty Sunday morning when an orb appeared to me in the sky, followed by a smaller orb that eclipsed the big orb, thus creating, well, a banana shape. And that banana shape told me, without using language, without using English words, that banana shape told me, it is up to you, Watto. It is up to you to build that better banana. And I experimented. I took it seriously. I went from town to town, finding every banana I could at a great personal sacrifice to me. It filled up my shed. It filled up my pantry. Eventually, I had to throw out all my pornographic silverware just to make room for more bananas in my drawers. But God damn it, I found a better banana. And I want you in on the ground floor. $800. $800. You could build a better banana and bring back that little yellow fella from space. I want you. Would you like to see? Are you ready to see what a better banana could look like?
Yes.
First, I will show you ways I failed. There was the sideways banana, a waste of time. There was a banana where the peel goes on the inside. It's not practical. I tried it. You'd think having a banana on the outside, that is a better banana. No! I tried rearranging the order of a banana where the top is in the bottom and the middle is at the top. Nothing! But I found it. This, ladies and gentlemen, this is a better banana. Look. Wait. That's not it. That's not it. No, you're doing it wrong. Ah! Okay, I got this. Here we go. It is your better. No. No. Bad, stupid, bad banana. But I got it. I swear to God. Just be good. Oh! 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 That's a worse banana than the original banana. I swear to God, don't leave me. Don't leave me like everyone else has done. I'm going to show you what a better banana looks like. I swear to God. Or I will kill myself. Oh, live on the internet. I will do it.
Okay. Okay, all right.
Thank you.
Wow. That, okay, I'm on board.
Yeah. $800 seems like a paltry sum to get started in the wonderful world of banana. Now.
I want to see him kill himself.
Yeah.
I was just going to see what ground control, because ground control's sort of been supposed to be supporting us through this whole thing. We've got a bunch of phone calls, but I'm waiting to answer those until maybe a little bit later.
Okay.
So everyone is here for the better bananas. And so if you like bananas, maybe just throw us a couple $300 or whatever you want to throw. Does that sound good?
Should we move? What are we doing now? The tape? We're going to the tape? All right.
Jeff, can maybe you could share parts? Maybe we could be like better at sharing. Okay, are we moving to the tape?
All right.
Hey there, folks. We're the cowboy magician duo of your dreams. I am Deputy Daddy, and here I got my son,
Tiny Hand Tim.
Now, hold on. Was this all this business, Tiny Hand Tim?
Deputy Daddy, I thought because I had a fancy new magic trick today, I could have a fancy new name.
Okay, all right. Well, I support that. Let's get that tiny little yellow lizard rat thing out of his space box. Show the people a little magic trick.
Well, all right, Daddy. Well, you see this here coin? Now, you may not always appreciate what you got, but if I tell you I could just make this disappear, you might think twice. Well, hot damn!
Now, son, that is the stupidest trick I ever seen in my entire life. How many magic classes did I give you to be having you do something embarrassing as this on television?
We are trying to get that little lizard boy
out of his space box, and ain't nobody gonna donate you doing little tiny hand tricks. Now, you know exactly what we gotta do. You prove yourself as a man right now. You know what we're gonna do?
What are we gonna do, Daddy?
You're gonna face me in a duel.
Oh, shoot. Well, all right, then.
Well, all right. All right, son. On the 10th step, we draw.
Yeehaw.
Yeehaw.
Informative.
Yeah.
Wow. That certainly was something. Okay, well, our next special guest is actually
our very own
Scram.
What are you talking about? I don't have an hat.
Okay, well, I guess if you need me to like cover for you, I've been practicing my impressions. Okay, ready? Is everyone ready?
Yeah, all right,
ready? This is my impression of a worm. Huh? But did you notice anything unusual? It's got teeth. It's a worm with teeth. Instead of like lip for sucking food. And it's dead.
Okay, that was horrible.
Never indulge your creative side ever again.
Well, watch. This is a dead worm with no teeth. Ready?
It's like exactly what I was doing, but better, honestly.
No, it was real.
Look, okay, stop, Jeff. You're terrible at this. You're terrible at this also. I'm not doing my act because I refuse to perform without being paid.
You're one of those people?
Oh, come on, Scram. We're all doing this together. We're getting already back home from space. Is there any way we can make this work?
You're right, Jeff. I have an idea for an act. I'll make it work.
Okay.
Okay. That's good. Well, while that happens, first of all, I want to say that, okay, the chat is saying they're not seeing it, that my worm, and that's hurtful. If I had feelings, that would be hurtful. But, okay, everyone, enjoy. Should we go to next?
Yeah, and while Scram's getting his act together, let's see our next act here.
And we can say it together. It's Troll!
High enough, no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket. Got that good soul in my feet. That hot blood in my pocket when it drops.
Okay, I'm gonna turn the music off because this is a serious thing that my favorite dancing partner, Artie. Artie's trapped in space. He can't dance with me. Do you know how sad that is? It's so sad. But I have a solution, which is I'm gonna paint a rainbow. And if I make a perfect rainbow, then I can make a wish, and I'll wish for Artie to come back. And also, you can buy the rainbow. Maybe you can buy the rainbow. Okay. Okay. What color goes first? Okay. Okay, well, I know what a rainbow is. I can read. I'm gonna go with red first. Okay, the red goes up here on the wall. Red! Okay, oh my gosh, look at the red! The red! Okay, what's next, everybody? I think that you're saying
green.
Orange. I know what a rainbow is. It's orange. It goes up here. No. Oh no. It's mixing with the red. Okay. That's better now. It's better now, right? Okay, what color is next? Yellow. I know that. The banana. The better banana, yellow. Look, here's a banana. Ooh. It ate the banana. Okay. Yellow on the wall. Just pour it on the wall. Make the rainbow. Okay, how much do you think you would pay for this? Because usually I sell my stuff for free.
Give me your Etsy link.
So maybe, hopefully, at least for free, someone will buy it. Okay, green. I know that. I know the green. Someone else wanted green early, but here we go. On the green rainbow. I think it's looking pretty good. Oh, phone call. Oh, no.
One of our pleasures.
What's the last color?
Blue.
It's blue? Oh, no. can fix the rainbow. I can fix it. I can fix the rainbow. No more dancing.
Oh, it was a valiant effort, but as our great friend Stephanie Phillips out there says, girl, I can feel you.
It is honestly relatable content.
Yeah. Okay.
Relatable
content. Amazing news, everyone. It looks like we're about 90% to our goal of $400, which comes to 90% of $400.
Good one, Jack.
That's obviously I know what that is. Okay, well, but that's incredible. Thank you so much. You hear that, Artie? We're gonna save you, and that's pretty amazing. All also, right. We've been getting a couple of calls on the line. Keep on calling.
That's so nice. But Ted and I have been thinking I'm gonna stay a little while with him, right, Ted?
No, we never agreed to that. I don't want him to stay here anymore. He's eating all my stuff. Please, I'll give you a dinner with the bus there. Just calm down.
Whoa, do you hear that? That's gonna match our viewers' contribution.
Yeah!
Oh my god, amazing.
All right, that's great.
All right, everyone, I came up with that.
Oh, good, yeah, it's fine, Scram, but the telethon's over.
Yes, it will be over after I do my act. My act is...
Electrocuting Jason.
Hey, everybody.
Jason, everybody.
That's Jason. Why? Jason, yeah. Why would you agree to this?
Because Jason has been doing a terrible job with the camera all day, and he deserves to die. So may I present my act, Jason being electrocuted?
Scram, this is not going to help.
Okay, fine. I know really what'll help. I'll electrocute Jason.
You can't electrocute Jason.
What's the angle? Where's the audience engagement?
Jason, why did you let Scram do this to you?
He's right. I've been doing a terrible job with the camera.
Agreed.
Okay, I'm going to pitch. Jeff, shut up. I do nothing, and we let ground control answer questions from an intermission, and then I torture Jason.
We already did that.
Yeah, but if
you're
torturing Jason, it takes
it to the next level.
It's a telethon.
It's pretty brilliant, honestly.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay, folks, leave your suggestions in the chat
and let us know how you'd like Scram to torture Jason. Also, the phone lines are open, so give us a call. And if you want to come on and tell us, feel free.
Yeah.
So we're just going to wait for some of those calls. Maybe Scram, you could think of like a couple ideas while we're waiting for people to come in with some thoughts.
Oh, yeah. Hold on one second.
Okay.
Down here. Okay. I'm gonna call this torture Fry the guy. Wait, check the shit.
Ooh, what about electrify the cutie pie?
Oh, that's pretty good.
What about both the adults?
Why are you encouraging
us? Hey guys, check out the song I just made. My name is Artie. I'm in space. I'm trapped here in space with Ted. I am Artie here in space. Guys,
keep going.
This is not how I intended to spend my holiday weekend, everyone.
Oh, we're getting a couple ideas. From Stephanie Phillips says we should feed Jason bananas until he dies.
Yeah.
Until Jason.
Don't take a lot of bananas, Stephanie. So
yeah, that's pretty good.
Amateur.
Hi, okay. Jason.
Any other thoughts? Because that's pretty good. That's pretty good. We have more bananas. We have a call.
A call. Let's answer the call.
Okay, we're going to answer the call.
Yeah, let's answer the call.
Hold on while I figure out. Okay.
Oh my gosh, here we go.
Welcome to Dials with Dirty. You're on the line. What?
Oh gosh. I love that lady.
I got a call from a voicemail. Wait, someone left us a voicemail.
Oh, what did they say?
Okay. try calling again. Try calling again, because I think I could get it this time.
Oh, hey, Jason. I see Scram's trying to kill you again. This is my lifelong friend, Ted. We just met an hour ago. Do you want to act out the Larry the Cable Guy movie? Witness Protection Agency for him?
I'm going to call the last person back.
What? How are we doing?
I'm going to call the last person back.
Oh, shit.
Okay, can we all hear it?
Hey, Ixie. There's other people here, Ixie.
Doofy Dog's back.
Hi.
This is descending into more madness than normal.
Hello, oh, this you're is on Dials for Darty.
You're such a team.
Wait, they got it. Hello. Hi, you're on the line. Who am I speaking to? What's your name? It's no one. Goodbye. Oh, someone else calling in.
Oh, no.
Well.
Hi, you're welcome to Dials for Darty. Hi, who is this? Okay. What's the way we should torture Jason?
I already got the jumper wheels, so.
The way we should torture Jason? Probably with lots of
Reitman? Oh, that doesn't work. Goodbye. Okay, we have another.
Chrissy, my self-esteem
cannot take you. Time for one more call.
We have time for one more caller. If anyone wants to call in,
yeah, I think the truth is that we don't have any more time. So why don't we just end this year by torturing Jason?
All right.
Finally.
Classic. Yeah.
All right. Well, we're torturing Jason Artie. Is going to reenact Larry the Cable Guy, Witless Protection agent. And what do you guys say? Enchiladas for dinner?
Yeah, enchiladas! Right.
Thanks for watching.
Yeah, we're like the Ninja Turtles, and enchiladas are our pizza.
Somebody stop me.
Okay, now, Kinchel. Thanks for joining. We'll see you
guys. My whole planet now.
Get Artie back from Friday now.
Goodbye. So long, farewell, adios, ain't adieu.
Wait, I'm still here. I'm gonna sing a song with Ted, my friend.
We gotta go back to the studio camera now.
Ground control to Major Tom.
Ground control to Major Tom. Take your protein pills and put your helmet on. Ground control to Major Tom. Commencing countdown, engines on. Check ignition and may God's love be with you. This is ground control to Major Tom. You've really made the grade. And the papers want to know whose shirt you wear. Now it's time to leave the capsule if you dare.
This is
ground control to ground control. control. I'm stepping through the door. And I'm floating in a most peculiar way. And the stars look very different today. For here am I sitting in my tin can. Far above the world. Planet Earth is blue, and there's nothing I can do.
Ba 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 ba.
Anhedonia.
Yay!
Don't touch me. Stay away.
All right. See you later.
Are we still streaming?
I think so.
I'm back on Earth. I took the train.
Thank you, Mom, Artie.
Thanks, Mom.
Yellow.
Oh. Oh, no.
No, I don't really want to. I really don't. I'll become green. We don't want me to be green.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, shoot. There's my head. Hi, Ixie. Are we still going?
Yeah, I mean, we're still live, I think.
What, where?
20 more minutes.
Are the people still
for 20?
Oh. Back
for 20 minutes, Artie.
I'm
still live on Facebook. You should probably...
Shoot your